Hello friends, how are you? Today I am going to discuss about how to check whether the given number is Hamming number or not. So before discussing about its logic, what is the meaning of Hamming number? Friends, if sum of cubes of digits of a given number is equal to the given number, then it is called Hamming number. So what is the meaning? So let us take one number. Say I am taking 153. So what are the digits we are having? In 153, we have 1, we have 5, we have 3. So you have to find out cubes of each digit. Say 1 cube and 5 cube and 3 cube. Then you have to find their sum. So what is the meaning? See here, I am adding their cubes, digits cubes. Okay. So 1 cube means 1 plus 5 cube. 5 into 5, 25, 25 into 5, 125, plus 3 into 3, 9, 9 into 3, 27. So 3 cube is 127. So 1 plus 125, 126, and 27, how much? 153. So if you see here, it is a original number. So that is the meaning. If both are same, then it is called Hamming number. So that is the definition here. If you see here, if sum of cubes of digits of a given number is equal to the given number, then it is called Hamming number. So what is the logic I am going to implement? It's very easy, friends. So what I will do is, from 153, I'll take one digit and I'll find the cube value, and I'll take one temporary variable and I will add this value, this cube value, into that number. Finally, I'll check the original value and this calculated value. If both are same, I can say Hamming number. Otherwise, I can say it is not Hamming number. So let me explain what the logic I am going to implement. So I am taking paint. What is that? Suppose if you take, friends, if you take n equal to 153, so I am taking one more variable. What is that? Say r equal to 0 I am taking, and s equal to 0 I am taking. Now what I am doing here, I am using two operators, division operator and mod division. I'll tell you why. First, what I am doing is r equal to n mod 10 I am doing. So if you use mod 10, then what will be happen? Say 153 mod 10, you will get 3. That means you will get last digit. How we are getting the last digit? Let me explain you, friends. So what I am doing, 10 here and 153 here. In 153, 10 how many times? 15 times. So what will be happen? 150. And 153 minus 150, you will get 3. So this 3 is called R. And how will you get this R? By using mod division operator. And this 15 is called quotient. And how will you get this quotient? Using division operator. That is the reason, friends. See here, n mod 10, 153 mod 10, I am getting 3 because of this mod operator. And friends, one more thing, s equal to s plus this r into r I am doing. So yes, initially the value of s is 0 plus r into r into r. Y means I am taking last digit and I am finding the cube value. What is the cube value? 3 into 3 into 3, so 27. So finally you will get 27. Okay, what is the value of r? Initially the value is 0, but after performing n mod 10, you will get 3. And one more thing, friends, and s equal to initially 0, so after finding s plus r into r into r, what is that value? So 27. And one more thing, from 153 you have taken 3 and you calculated its cube value, but I don't want 3, correct? Right? So that is the reason what I am doing is n equal to n by 10. So what is the value? 153 by 10. So already we have seen we got 15 quotient. If you are using division operator, you will get 15. So what is the value of n here? 153. So what I am doing is, see, no problem. So not 153. Now the value is, what is it? 15. From 153, 15, I mean 3 gone, the latest value is 15 only. This is step 1. And one more thing, friends. Step 2. I mean, how many times we have to do like this? It's very easy, friends. You have to check n value. If it is 0, then stop the process. And you have to compare s value and n value. If both are same, you can say Armstrong number. Otherwise, you can say it's not Armstrong number. Okay, but see here, 15, n equal to not 0, then repeat the step once again. So this is called step number 2. In step number 2, what I am doing, same step, r equal to n mod 10. What is the value of n? 15 mod 10. You will get how much? 5 only. Let me show you, friends, how you are getting. I am dividing 15 with 10. And in 15, 10, how many times? Only one time. 1 into 10, 10. So what is the remainder here? 5 only. And this is called, what is that, remainder. And friends, one more thing, this is called, which operator? It will give you remainder, division up, I mean mod division operator. And this is called quotient. This operator, which operator will give division operator. So that is the reason we got, 15 mod 10, we got 5. So initially the value of current value of r is 3, but this 3 will be replaced by 5. And one more thing, now I have to find out s value. What about s value? S equal to s plus r into r. Friends, already in s we have 3 cube value. What is that? 27 plus r cube. Now we have to find out 5 cube value. 5 into 5 into 5, what is it? 125. So equal to 152, you got it. So what is the value of, what is the latest value of s? 152. So this 27 will be replaced by which value? 152. And one more thing, friends, and already from 15 you have taken 5 and you found, you calculated its cube value and added it to s variable. Now I don't want 5, that is the reason what I am doing here. N equal to n by 10 I am doing. What about n value? What is the current value? 15 only. 15 by 10 you will get 1 only. See here, friends, already you got 1 because of this division operator. And this 15 will be replaced by, what is that value? 1 only. And friends, you have to check whether n equal to 0 or not. If n is 0, I'll stop the process, but n is not 0, n is 1, then I have to repeat these steps one more, once again. So which step I am going to perform now? Third step. This is step 3. In step 3 also same thing, r equal to n mod 10. What is the n value? 1 mod 10. How much you are getting? 1 mod 10, I think 1 only you are getting here. Now what about r value? R is 5. Now this 5 will be replaced by 1. And one more thing, friends, let me show you what I am doing here. I am dividing 1 with 10. Okay. So in 1, 10 how many times? 0 times. That is the reason. 1, 0. What is the remainder here? You will get 1 as remainder. So this is called remainder. And which operator is giving? Mod operator. And here this is called quotient. Which operator is giving? Like division operator only. This is mod division, this is division operator. That's it, friends. And what about r value? I updated. Now I am finding s value. What about s value? S equal to s plus r into r. Already s contains and 3 cube value as well as 5 cube value. What is the sum of 3 cube and 5 cube? 152 plus, I am adding 1 cube value. How much? 1 into 1 into 1, you will get 1 only. So what is the value here? 153. From already 1 I have taken, so I don't want 1. That is the reason what I am doing, n equal to n by 10. What is the value here? 0 only. See here, friends, you are getting 0. And now what about 153? 153 will be replaced by, 152 will be replaced by 153. What about n value? N also 0. So stop the process. Stop the process. And we have to compare n value with s value. But the thing is, we performed some operations on n value. So we have to compare original value. We have to compare s value with the original value of n, but the latest value is 0. So in this one, what we are going to do is, whenever you are getting the value from the keyboard, just take one more variable, say integer n1 equal to n. Now we are storing n value into n1, right? So 153 we are storing into n1. So that n1, we have to compare this n1 with this s. If both are same, then we can say it is a Amshank number. Otherwise, we can say it is not Amshank number. So this is the logic I am going to implement, friends. And friends, still if you are having any issues, and if you want to give any feedback on my teaching, please let me know in the comment section. It will be very helpful to me. And let me implement the logic, and we'll see the output, friends. And for this one, already I have taken one class. The name of the class is called Amshank number. In that, I have taken one main method as well, and I am creating one object for scanner class. So what is the use of this scanner class? You can get the output from keyboard. And this SOP, what I am doing, I am trying to display one message on the console. And what about this line? I am getting one number from the keyboard. That's it. So after this, as I said, I am taking one more temporary variable n. Why I am taking this temporary variable? Because we are going to perform some operations on n value, but we need original value, right? That's the reason I have taken one temporary variable, and I am storing into that n1. That's it. And I am taking one while loop, friends. Why I am taking while loop? Because if you see step 1, step 2, step 3, in each and every step, all statements, so some group of statements are there, right? Same steps, but multiple times we have to execute it. So that is the reason we have to go for loops. But you can take for loop, you can take do while, right? But why I am taking while loop? Because I don't know the number of iterations. That is the reason I am going for while loop. That's it, friends. There is no great logic behind this. And in while, what is the condition I have to give? Blindly, n should not be 0. If n is 0, then no need to do anything. Come out and display whatever you want. Okay. And what is the first step, friends? We need to find out r value and s value. Before that, let me take integer r equal to 0 and s equal to 0. I have taken two integer variables and assigned initialized it to 0 and 0 corresponding. I mean, respectively. So next, r equal to what I am doing, n mod 10 I am taking. And that's it. Now, s equal to, 1 minute, friends. S equal to S plus, what is that? R into R into R. Nothing, friends. I am taking last digit and I am finding the cube value and adding into the test. That's it. Next, N equal to N by 10. Why? Because in the first step, we are taking last digit. So I don't want last digit. That's the reason I am extracting. That's it. And come out, friends. And which number you have to, the calculated value, computed value is available in S, but original value is not in N1. Make sure, friends, everyone will do mistake here. Just cross check. And just if both are same, definitely I can say, what is that? It is Amshank number. One minute, friends. Sys out and give control space bar. You will get system.out.println instead of typing everything. So what we can say, it is a Amshank number. Else means was, is both are not same, then you can say it's not Amshank number. So coding board has been completed, friends. Let me test it. So first I'll pass 153. Already we have discussed it, right? 153 is the Amshank number. I'm expecting, what is that? If I give 153, I'm expecting the Amshank. Same output I got it. Let me test it for another number, say 123. And it's not Amshank number, right? Why? Because 1 cube plus 2 cube plus 3 cube is not equivalent to 123. Friends, please let me know from 1 to 1000 how many Armstrong numbers are there and what are those. Please let me know in the comment box. And thanks a lot, friends. Thanks a lot for watching this video. And still, if you are having any issues, please let me know in the comment section. Thanks.